classic result in theoretical linear algebra is that given any matrix A, it may or may not be the case that it's diagonalizable, but what is the case is that you can find a matrix X such that X inverse A times X equals a matrix that is block diagonal. Each of these blocks on the diagonal is a Jordan block, so it has this form. It could be a 1x1 Jordan block. If all of these Jordan blocks are 1x1, then the matrix, in fact, is diagonalizable. But in general, it may be the case that more or even all of these blocks are proper Jordan blocks that are not 1x1. The diagonal of each Jordan block then are eigenvalues of this matrix. It's entirely possible that this eigenvalue is equal to that eigenvalue. Okay. The total number of times that an eigenvalue appears along the diagonal of this matrix is then the algebraic multiplicity of that eigenvalue. It's the multiplicity that that eigenvalue is a root of the determinant. The geometric multiplicity of an eigenvalue equals the number of Jordan blocks that have that eigenvalue as its eigenvalue. In other words, it's equal to the number of linearly independent eigenvectors associated with that eigenvalue. Now, this is a very nice result. One can prove its existence. We can spend a lot of time on this. But the fact is that it has no real practical value. I know of no practical linear algebra software library that even provides a routine for computing it. So, it's a nice theoretical result. It allows us to discuss things like the algebraic and geometric multiplicity of an eigenvalue, but we're not going to spend any more time on it because we're interested in how we actually take theory and make it practical.